First at 11, it's a video that's been viewed more than 5 million times. Empty library shelves at Mandarin Middle School, taken by a substitute teacher who says he's at a loss for words as the school reviews the content of its books following guidelines from the state. Schools are now required to review their libraries and teachers' classroom book collections to make sure that they don't violate certain subject matter outlined by the state of Florida. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us. I'm Heather Crawford.
And I'm Anthony Austin. It's an issue we've reported on for several months now, and tonight, On Your Side's Andrew Badillo spoke with the man who took that video you just saw. He's also a parent, and Andrew, what is his children's school district saying about all of this?
Yeah, Anthony, Brian Covey says his children's school district hasn't said a word. His kids were in the middle of literacy week when the books were taken from their classroom. Now, Covey says there's been no word on which books will return and when. He says it's been a tough conversation with his kids, one he admits he doesn't have the answers to.
I have no answers for my kids on why this is happening.
Brian Covey's kids came home from school late last week, saying books were taken out of their classroom. A substitute teacher at Mandarin Middle School, Covey decided to see if his school did the same thing. He was met with empty shelves.
I decided to share that because it blew my mind that that type of drastic action was felt like it was needed.
Now, with specific guidance and direction from the Florida Department of Education, we are launching a formal review of our classroom libraries.
Last week, Duval County Public Schools announced in this video that it will be reviewing books to make sure they fall in line with state law that went into effect last July. It includes vetting books for pornography. A teacher in violation could be charged with a third-degree felony. But instead of books being plucked off the shelves, they were swept completely clean.
They made it sound like this is something that they had been planning for all year, and this was just the next step in the process, but it was a July 1st, the pieces didn't make sense to me as a parent.
Duval County Public Schools says it will send an approved list to teachers while remaining books are under review. Covey says one of the books was part of an incentive program that promises kids an ice cream social at the end of the year.
It breaks my heart because my kids are trying their best to, they love school, they love their media teacher, and when they heard that their media teacher was tearfully having to announce that they were removing the resource from the curriculum, it broke their heart.
Well, Duval County Public Schools says trained media specialists are conducting those book reviews. We asked DCPS how many trained media specialists it has, but it didn't answer our question, instead directing us to the blog post about the State Department of Education telling Florida school districts to err on the side of caution in their book reviews. Live in the studio, Andrew Badillo, First Coast News, On Your Side.